Would you like to easily navigate your QuickBooks Online account and possibly sign up for free? Well, then you should watch this video, Set Up and Navigate QuickBooks Online for this sales tax course. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. This video will show you how to sign up for QuickBooks Online and navigate the interface. It's part of the QuickBooks Online Crash Course. That's a different course from this sales tax course. It's a good clear demonstration of how to attempt to sign up for the free trial version. It's a good demo on how to navigate the QuickBooks Online interface, and that's why I included this crash course video as part of the sales tax course. After the sign up, I will show you the three lists that you must then input in order to follow step by step in this sales tax course. Preparing your QuickBooks Online account. Most software courses require that you purchase the software in order to follow along. That's if you choose to learn by repeating what you see step by step. I will try to help you get the software for free. I cannot promise that you will have a free account. The free versions are only available in the United States. If you cannot get one free, then you must purchase the QuickBooks Online software if you choose to follow along step by step. You need a separate QuickBooks Online account for this course. You should not enter the transactions that you see in this course into your actual QuickBooks Online company file. So this will be a demonstration of exactly how to sign up. You can get the Plus version for 30 days free. This is what we will be using in the course and what will be shown here in this demonstration of how to sign up. You could instead watch the following video that will show you how to sign up for free for the Accountant's Edition. The Accountant's Edition is free indefinitely and looks similar enough for you to use for this course. So, you must sign up by using an email address that has never been used before with a QuickBooks Online account. The website address to sign up will always change, so you have to be patient and flexible. If the web address is different from what you see here because you are watching this video after they changed it, well then don't worry. The new address to sign up will be in the description text of the page of this video. They may have even changed the exact steps or change the interface that you see. This will happen all the time when you use QuickBooks Online. Just use your best judgment to try to activate the fewest features possible so we can go faster with the rest of the setup. On the day that I am making this video, this is the website address to sign up for the free 30-day trial version. Don't forget to save your username and password. I suggest that you prepare them in a text document and then keep them separate from the login information for your real QuickBooks Online company account. So, I come here and I paste. This is exactly the web address. Hit enter and you will come to this page. Now, in order to get the three free 30-day trial version, you know, a lot of stuff pops up, this center button will give you the ability to do that. Because if you select any of these right now, QuickBooks Online will assume you're ready to buy. But if you click this button for a free 30-day trial, then after you click for the free 30-day trial, they'll ask you about payroll, or at least lately they will, and you don't want any payroll there. So we just click select for the plus version. Actually, now they're asking you if you want to add payroll, and we will click continue without payroll. So it explains a little bit about the plan under the assumption that you will buy it after 30 days. And then you click checkout. So now we're ready to sign up, and I have my username as the email address that will be associated with the account. And of course, mobile number, and my password I already made in advance, a password that I know satisfies the conditions that they're asking for. Now that we have everything, we click sign up with email and give it a moment. Now, remember, they think you're trying to buy the software. Be very careful. Click continue with trial. Now, they're going to ask us a few basic questions, but we're just going to put in the minimum amount to be able to get right into the account to start working. So this is Vonda Video. And spelling doesn't count. How would you describe what your business does? In a real situation, you would type in whatever's necessary, but you do not check the box that we're transferring over from desktop. Click Next. Now, we might want to do these things, but not during the crash course. During the crash course, we select as little as possible so we can get directly into the software to start working. So don't click on any of these. Click Next. Now, we do not have employees, so click No and click Next. Now, the quickest and easiest way to manage this is to click that you're the owner. This way, you're the main administrator, and you can simply use all the tools without a problem. So double-click Owner. Now, do you have an accountant or a bookkeeper? In our course, we click No. I do it all myself. Then click Next. Now, we don't want to use bank feeds at the beginning. You will learn a little bit about bank feeds later on, but the proper way to learn at the beginning is to manually add transactions. Now we click All Set, and now that you've signed up, you can input the three list items that we need. First, you should put in these three customers, and you may well notice we will only input the name just to save time, and you can pause the video to read the names as you record them in your new QuickBooks Online account. Now, here are the two accounts in the chart of accounts that you must add to set up for this sales tax course: cash and bank, which is a bank type of account, and the detail type is checking, and the only other account you have to put is accounts receivable, and that's an accounts receivable type of account. The last list you have to put is the list of products and services. They are both non-inventory parts. You will put apples as $100 each, and that will be connected to sales income, and bananas can be $1,000 each, and that will also be connected to sales income. If you don't know how to put in any of these lists, you can take an introductory class to learn how to input these three lists before you start this course. Once you finish setting up and putting in the lists, we will then go to the next video where we will start charging and collecting sales tax.